The race for a COVID vaccine is unlike any other pandemic in recent history. It took 8 years for an effective Ebola vaccine, 6 months for a safe H1N1 vaccine, and it's possible a COVID vaccine won't be much longer. But we're not comparing apples to apples. Decades of prior research on influenza made the H1N1 vaccine possible, a luxury scientists don't have now.
One thing I always say is expect the unexpected. When you're starting something new in vaccine development, things will occur.
Dr. Jesse Goodman is an infectious disease physician and professor at Georgetown University. He formerly served as the FDA's chief scientist, where he led the response to the 2009 H1N1 flu pandemic.
This is a bigger challenge than we had in 2009 because we could build on proven vaccines where we had pretty high confidence in manufacturing quality, and in their safety and in their performance.
Yet there isn't high confidence in vaccine development for the coronavirus family. Scientists have struggled to produce quality antibodies for other strains. In fact, animal models showed it made the disease worse.
That's an important potential safety concern, that these vaccines protect and don't have this theoretical risk of making the disease worse.
Since you've been through this before, what are you most concerned about?
Even though there hasn't been a hint of it yet, could there be much rarer, more serious side effects?
It's those questions that point to the FDA's vaccine monitoring process, a team Goodman led for 5 years.
The public is relying on that process not only being thorough, but transparent. From your perspective, what exactly should be public?
So I think the data on safety and effectiveness that comes out of these phase three trials should be, you know, fully available. Everything you want to know about adverse events, everything you want to know about safety, where we don't have all the data in yet, potentially, if there was an emergency use, it should be clear what the gaps are.
If there are gaps, Americans deserve to know there were no shortcuts to compromise safety.
Once a COVID vaccine is approved and in use across the country, the FDA and CDC will continue to monitor safety and any potential side effects through a federal reporting system called VAERS. Stephanie Sierra, ABC 7 News.